My advice to you as a medical professional is that you should stop playing. These were the words that changed my life. I torn the cartilage out of my right shoulder and got the injury that ended my career, really, and the bottom just dropped out of my world. I played professionally for just over 12 years, and it went like that. It went in a blink of an eye. I didn't start on this journey with the idea of undertaking a world first project or even having the opportunity to undertake several. You know, for me, that was about channeling my energies into something positive as opposed to something destructive. And when I was forced to retire, I was in a pretty dark place psychologically, emotionally, physically as well. My perception was that, you know, I wasn't ready to retire. I didn't want to retire. I hadn't achieved all that I wanted to. And I think more importantly, it wasn't on my terms. But ironically, and also I think wonderfully, you know, you could argue it's one of the best things that's ever happened to me. But at the time, it was brutal. But it's how I found mountains. I guess mountains and the outdoors, you know, saved me, really. It was a number of serendipitous events and people that opened the door to this chapter of my life and what I do now, and ultimately, you know, led to my first project, which was the 737 Challenge, where in 2011, I became the first person to climb the seven summits and stand on the North and the South Pole in the same calendar year. You know, of all the emotions I feel now, sat here, ironically, where it all ended or started, you know, it's just gratitude. My overriding feeling is gratitude, because from the worst period of my life, I'm privileged to earn a living doing what I love again. Maybe rugby was the precursor to what I do now, and maybe this is what I'm supposed to do. And now I wouldn't swap anything for what I've been lucky enough to attempt, experience and achieve in this chapter of my life.